Texas.
Plano, Texas.
I forgot where I was.
Yeah.
Because I was too.
It's been
you know,
a long
I was too inside of the video game.
Yeah.
I was not in Plano, Texas. I was on Final Destination.
Exact. Coming at you live from Final Destination. I hope not on game one featuring these two characters.
Oh, but even better? Worse?
Honestly, Smashville is kind of goated for both of these, so we'll take it.
Yeah, so this is D-Win and Fox, both pretty much character specialists,
yes.
You'd call them.
Fox.
Play these certain guys, but
ooh, Fox, the biggest believer in Terry you've ever met in your life.
Yeah, until Kazuya was announced, and then he was like, "Oh, Kazuya's gonna save me." But you know, sticking to the Fox or sticking to the Terry, I'm sorry for now.
Yeah. Oh, great use of the invincibility. That's really important because otherwise, down smash is so free against Terry. You have to go for those inputs.
Yeah, and oh, the trample F tilt versus F tilt max win. Yep, every time.
Yeah. Okay. Good on Fox for being consistent with that. That is not easy because you have to hold down on the way you're recovering up.
Yeah.
He shielded out of it? I thought that was just going to be a combo, but I guess he wasn't popped up with a down tilt.
Yeah, he needs the down tilt first for that to work out. And, okay, KO punch off the board.
Yeah, KO punch, but Terry keeps his win condition until you kill him. So
yeah, Terry gets as many KO punches as he needs.
Yeah. Good for Demon, though, was able to get that knocked out. He can recover distance-wise, for sure.
Yeah,
he's got to be careful. Oh, he's dead.
Yeah, great cover on the roll, but Fox a player. I see him edgeguard more on Terry than anyone else, because you can go off stage with Fair and with neutral B. We might be seeing that later, but
yeah,
not
you
yet.
Do have plenty of resources to recover. I love the little special cancels on aerial pressure on platforms.
Yeah.
You get to eject from the situation, and then worst case, if you hit them, you get decent damage.
It gets super ugly because people like regular getting into that nair.
Yeah, that's Ryu-esque. Get that nair down air. Clean kills at mid percents. Would have killed anybody. Didn't have to be Mac.
Yeah, it didn't really matter at that point, but it's not the easiest combo, so it's good that Fox was solid on it.
Oh, the up tilt waits for the air dodge, catches the jump here. Can he punish that?
Yeah.
Unfortunately,
I'd like to see like a little bit better defense from Fox. He's taking a ton of damage just from a single up tilt with these air dodges and these double jumps.
Yeah, there's a lot. I mean, sometimes when you're not super familiar with the character, you give air dodges that really Mac's not going to follow up. Other characters might. Great DI.
Yeah, seriously.
But no KO punch online, and I mean, he's going to get one if he lives all the way to the next stock, but geez, it's going to be difficult.
Like, fighting Terry is so tough because it's like, okay, I'm just going to die to down tilt or jab, and then eventually, I'm just going to die to the best dash attack ever.
Right.
This is so good.
Man!
he survives. Okay, but the next one for sure.
Oh, no. No opportunities.
No
gets
chance.
The back air.
No chance, but... Yeah, you'll see Terry's, they just love to rip those once you get past 140, 150, and you can't really blame them because it's such a good move.
Right, it's not super easy to punish.
Yeah.
If punishable at all.
Yeah.
And it covers a huge distance.
Yeah, I've seen some ugly, like, it catches jump with the last hit at the ledge.
The shoulder reach is pretty high.
Yeah, totally. But, I mean, I think the decider for that game was that quick nair dare, right?
Definitely.
Everything else was pretty much dead even up until then.
It changed
and even
pace.
After.
Because Demon was leading for a while. But then once Fox took the lead, I think the lead is so important against Mac, especially when there's platforms involved, because you can just kind of eject from situations and say, I'm actually going to play the pace I want.
Yeah, I was like, I don't want to fight right now. It's my choice, not yours. But.
Ooh, surprised that Fair actually got through the smash attack.
Oh, the spot dodge attack going straight through the down tilt. We forget about Terry. Terry's still DLC, guys. Like, don't forget. Terry's still DLC.
Definitely don't forget.
A lot of people forgetting, but...
Factor, that's the biggest punish on get-up attack I've ever seen.
You're not the only one with a mechanic that does amazing things.
Ooh,
good
going
delay. For something, but... Oh, this could be bad. Okay.
Ooh, I don't think that one was invincible.
Yeah, that wasn't the empowered up B, but...
That could have been ugly. There we go. Fox was able to make it back, though.
Sitting. Yeah, but not without 72% real quick.
Oh, ooh, that's
spacing.
Right, just out of range of the get-up attack. Mac reaches pretty far with those gloves.
Yeah.
But that means his hands are sticking out pretty far for the down smash to connect.
Yeah, I feel like that's really where these Terry mains get their... get their mileage is using these moves that you don't realize Terry has like infinite good moves. All of his moves are pretty great, but finding those situations, right?
Speaking of, Go Mode Active was able to steal half the stage with Buster Wolf.
Yeah, he gets two pretty good moves in this mode.
Board the platforms.
Yeah, being smart about it this time, not going for the Buster Wolf.
He got real aggressive with that going off stage.
I thought someone was getting stage spiked.
I definitely thought there was going to be something silly, but D-Win has KO Punch online. Now he's playing board the platforms to get through the invincibility. He gets behind.
Yeah, this is a rude thing that Max do, is they pick Battlefield. Max love Battlefield! What was that off of? Down tilt? I don't even notice.
He caught a roll.
Yeah.
He caught a roll.
Yeah, I know he got the tech situation, but...
Yeah. I don't know. Two KO punches feels bad.
Yeah, I mean...
But both times, it wasn't even like he needed the KO punch.
Yeah.
It was just he put the opponent in a terrible situation. Was like, all right, well, I'm going to kill you for it.
Yeah, and D-Win, like, super smart player. Like, he definitely knew he wanted tech situations, right? Like, he was like, okay, I have KO punch. I can't just use it raw. Like, it's a little bit more delicate than that. I got to get them into one of these tech situations. And he went for it both times, and it worked out.
That's impressive. I want to point out, D-Win, I think it was last week,
yeah, he beat Drago on Min-Min.
Drago in the Min-Min Mac matchup, yeah. Which is horrendous.
So probably like one of the worst matchups in the game, yeah. Between two characters.
So when we're saying character loyalist, we mean it.
Of course.
They're not going anywhere else.
Yeah.
There's a reason that they're here.
Yeah. Well, to be fair, Fox does play some other characters in Bragg. He's pretty comfortable on some of his other characters. How much they've won him, yet to be seen.
Right.
But he's definitely comfortable.
Known for the Terry.
Known for the Terry, for sure.
And right now, he's putting on a lot of damage, really, with that Terry.
Putting on a lot of damage, but starting to learn, damage doesn't mean everything when I'm just charging up my opponent's bar.
True. You're giving him that KO meter.
Yeah.
He is very close to full, and also really good at equalizing damage quick.
Yeah.
Especially with smash
attacks. I do not know where 58% came from, to be honest.
Yeah. Oh,
and that's not how you want to lose your stock. Finally going for one of those edge guards, but he pays for it.
He might have even been ready for attack in that situation.
Should be it.
Yeah, he's dead. He can't refresh the side B.
Yeah.
So even percent, he's got some invincibility. Yeah, use that up smash to cover that landing. That's about all that you get.
Yeah. Oh, he wanted it. If he let go a moment earlier, it would have worked out.
Yeah. That's one way to deal with your opponent's projectile. Get in their face and use your armor move.
Yeah. And the funny thing about that is, it would be Fox's choice to just wait behind it, right? But it's just so natural for you to run behind your projectile like that. But people get hit by the F smash a lot, but this is kill percent.
This is absolutely kill percent.
And honestly, I don't really know if Fox could do a combo right now that kills Mac.
Yeah, I think he's out of a lot. I mean, maybe.
You do not want to be doing those.
Committing to projectiles is not the play right there.
Yeah, it like jump, roll, air dodge around.
Yeah.
Make yourself invincible, but that neutral B, not doing him any favors, and D1 is up a stock, but maybe not for long.
Ooh, okay, really aggressive. I love the play for the back air there, actually.
Yeah.
It just wasn't fast enough, unfortunately.
Yeah, D1 just barely snapping. And how are you going to find this kill, Fox? There it is. There it is.
Broken dash attack, the last lingering hitbox that was still
strong. Oh, no, that was like one of the first. That was a super early hit of that move.
It has
infinite moves.
It lasts for 500
never
frames.
Yeah. But yeah, definitely the end of the strong hitbox.
Yeah.
Murking him. Oh my gosh, you're alive. All right.
Okay, we've got go mode active. We don't.
Okay.
Oh.
This is good.
Okay. Go
one
mode
hit,
active.
One hit wins. Last hit wins.
There's no KO punch. Don't get him punched.
That's it. Good job, Fox. Oh my gosh. That gets ugly because the jab doesn't always work perfectly on regular getup like that. Like, sometimes they get their shield up, right?
Yeah, and especially also at the very edge of the stage.
Uh-huh.
Not super consistent.
Oh, yeah, for sure. Or they'll fall out of
STI
jab two.
Fall out.
Or you'll miss the Buster Wolf, but...
You'll get caught on the lip of the stage and not go far enough.